This will be a high-level overview of DataRobot's core AI production capabilities. Nearly everything covered applies equally to generative AI or predictive AI solutions and applies equally to any tech stack and ecosystem. DataRobot offers one unified platform to build, operate, and govern AI. This overview focuses on the operate and govern aspects. As a new DataRobot user, your model registry and your console views will be blank. Conversely, mine has 70 deployments being monitored and governed. It can be hard to understand the robust functionality available when your view is empty, so let me take you on a quick tour. In the console view, I get a quick overview of all activity. I can filter the view of these 70 solutions based on their green, yellow, red status, their importance, build environment, or prediction environment. At a glance, I can view the deployment with the greatest prediction volumes or the most recently created, and examine the environments and owners for each. Also at a glance, I can see the prediction environments in which all my organization's models operate, and I can create new environments and share them with coworkers. Here I can check in on all the batch jobs running against all 70 deployments. These are all examples of what we mean when we say we can help you confidently manage and govern AI at scale. An organization with 70 AI models in production has different needs than an organization with 2 AI models in production. But if that org with 2 models in production adopts a standard platform early in their AI journey, they'll be able to scale quickly and confidently. Let's take a look inside a few of these deployments. I've selected this deployment to show that a generative model built in Python outside of DataRobot can be deployed using our GenAI drop-in environment. This deployment has numerous LLM-specific metrics defined to monitor its output quality and costs. I've selected this deployment to show the service health monitoring over time, the ability to track data drift, including text drift, represented by the size and colors of these words, and tracking accuracy of generative outputs. This particular metric is tied to a thumbs up, thumbs down button that the human user clicks after reading the generated response. I've selected this deployment to show challenger models. In this case, the turquoise model is the champion, but the purple model is consistently performing better on all essential metrics. DataRobot offers a one-click hot swap action to initiate a model replacement and log that activity for traceability. I've selected this deployment to show retraining policies. This deployment has a calendar-based and a trigger-based retraining policy. It creates a new DataRobot project every week and adds the top model across experiments as a challenger. You have a lot of control over the retraining process. Decide between retraining a specific blueprint only, running a comprehensive search, or various options in between. Decide between saving the results, adding as a challenger, or initiating a replacement based on your governance workflows. I've selected this deployment to show the fairness and humility tabs. Within fairness, you can monitor your production models against 8 different definitions of fair. These can vary by use case. From the settings area, you can define custom thresholds and notifications. Within humility, you can define rules for overriding or logging predictions that meet certain criteria. Here you see rules for overriding very uncertain predictions and logging predictions made on zip codes and counties not well represented in the training data. I've selected this deployment to show batch scoring jobs and database integrations. This deployment reads from 3 Snowflake tables, does all the feature engineering, scores each row, and writes the predictions back to a different Snowflake table. Batch jobs are easy to configure using the provided connectors. Once the job is defined, put it on a schedule and only intervene if there is a problem. There's plenty more to show, but I think you get the idea with these deployment capabilities. At this point, you may be curious how these deployments came to be listed here in the first place. This is best explained with a few slides. There are five primary choices for workflows and some variations on each of those five. Notice that four of the five involve bringing models into the model registry. At a high level, the important thing to know is that you can use DataRobot AI production to deploy models written in any open source language or library and expose a production quality REST API to support real-time or batch predictions, all with monitoring, management, and governance. DataRobot is flexible to deploy anything you've created using the tools on the top to the infrastructure listed on the bottom. The model registry is where you will maintain version control and test your models before deployment. When you build your models with DataRobot, you can add them to the registry with a single click. For models built outside DataRobot, we offer the guided custom model workshop to help you assemble and test models before deploying. This is an example of a predictive model with limited dependencies and supporting files. Conversely, this is an example of a generative chatbot with more extensive requirements and supporting files. A complete tour of registry and custom model workshop is out of scope for this overview, but there are many educational resources available to you to help you get started. I hope you enjoyed this high-level tour of a DataRobot user account that is populated with many diverse use cases and model types running in many different environments. A platform approach to productionalizing your AI brings consistency and visibility to all your AI assets. This allows you to avoid AI chaos and focus on delivering business value.